Hi, so in this video we're going to be looking at indices. So what we're talking about is looking at numbers written in their index form. So the index form of 4 times 4 times 4 is 4 cubed, where the 3 is up in the air. The 3 is called the index number or the power, and the 4 is the base number. So the 3 says we're going to multiply 4 by itself 3 times. Now on this slide I've got the indice rules that you would have had from GCSE, so they shouldn't be new to you. So if I have y to the power of a times y to the power of b, I get y to the power of a plus b. So example of this is 2 cubed times 2 to the power of 4 would give me 2 to the power of 7, because 3 plus 4 gives you 7. Here I've got a power of a power, so this y to the power of a all to the power of b is the same as 1 to the power of a times b. So 2 cubed all squared is the same as 2 to the power of 6, because 3 times 2 will give you 6. Y to the power of a divided by y to the power of b is the same as y to the power of a minus b. So 2 to the power of 5 over 2 to the power of 3 is the same as 2 to the power of 2, because 5 take away 3 will give you 2. And when I use a fraction line, that's actually the same as dividing. So a fraction 1 over 2 is the same as 1 divided by 2. Okay, so on this slide we've got the new rules which come in for A level. The first one we have is y to the power 1, sorry, minus a, and what that does, that minus means that you take y to the power of a and you put it on the bottom of a fraction. Okay, so minus takes whatever you got and you put it on a fraction, so on the bottom of the fraction. So 2 to the power of minus 3 is the same as 1 over 2 cubed. Rule 5, where this is a fractional power, so when you've got y to a power that is a fraction, 1 over n will give you the nth root of y. So this is, for example, 8 to the power of a third is the third root of 8. And so what number multiplied by itself 3 times gives you 8? The answer is 2. So if the number is n is 2, you get a half, that's just a normal square root. If it's 4, you get the fourth root, and so on. Okay, so this question is sort of question which comes up. You've got y to the power of m over n, which can be written as y to the 1 over n all to the power of m, and that just used the rule from before. So if I multiply out 1 over n times m, I get m over n. So this can be written as the nth power of y, so that's just taking it out of this index notation, all to the power of m. So it's best to see this use an example. If I have 4 to the power of 3 over 2, that's the same as square root of 4, or the second root of 4, all to the power of 3. And then if I take the square root of 4, that's 2, and then I cube it, I'll get 8. And then the final rule is anything to the power of 0 is 1, so 8 to the power of 0 is 1, and that's something that you should learn. Okay, I hope that's helpful. I'm going to do you a video now on exam style questions. So hopefully you want to go and see that.